Hi guys, on today's menu, Navajo tacos. Take a look at how beautiful these are. They smell good, they taste good, and they're very easy to make. You're watching The Bear Pantry Show. Navajo tacos are not much different than regular tacos. I start off with a little bit of ground beef or ground turkey and I put it in a skillet and make it loose. While the meat browns, I'm going to do the bread. 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, a little bit of salt, and we're going to make the dough with some milk. Now, this is the same recipe that I used to make our Belizean fried jacks or fried cakes, but after talking to my cousin Tim's mother-in-law, who is Native American, she told me that this is the same recipe that they use to make the fried breads to make Navajo tacos. So this is why I wanted to show you guys how it's done. Now you guys know how I do it, right? I add the liquid a little bit at a time because I don't want to overwet the dough, and then I have to fix the problem by adding more flour, and then that changes the taste and the consistency of the dough. So now it's time for me to dump it on the countertop. I've washed my hands and dried them off so that I cannot have any sticky dough on my hands. It makes kneading a whole lot easier, okay? So now it's time to cut it into 3 equal-sized pieces. That's all we're going to get from this little bit right here because it's only a cup of flour. But this is going to be more than enough. The tacos are going to be big. I roll all 3 pieces into balls because that makes it a little bit more easy when using the rolling pin to make the disc or the circular, you know, type thing for the taco. Now it's time to check on the meat. I have salt, chili powder, cayenne, and black pepper in this bowl. I'm going to dump it all in here. You can use whatever spices you like. This is our Belizean ricotta. I use this to replace paprika because I don't like the taste of paprika. In the past, this is all we could get the ricotta like this, okay? Like a piece of clay. This comes from the achiote tree or the lipstick tree, and it's just for coloring. You can get it in this canister, the little package, or the block of clay from my dad's website, bluefield-prod.com. Now I'm going to let the ground beef cook and just add a little bit of water a little bit at a time to make sure it doesn't burn. I've added some onions. I don't have any cilantro. I kind of ran out, so I'll have to make do. Just add the water a little bit at a time and let this go for about 40 minutes. Then set it aside. Now it's time to grate the cheese. I'm using sharp cheddar because that's what I like. I'm using the large hole in the grater because I wanted to look real pretty when I dress the taco. And now it's time to roll the dough. And I want to roll all 3 pieces before I start frying, all right? So there's an art to this. When you're coming back with a rolling pin, you kind of have to flare out to the right and flare out to the left to make this circular or like a disc. Joe is way better at this than I am, but it's okay because, you know, it's our stuff. You know, doesn't have to be perfect. So here I am over at the stove and I'm adding some canola oil because that's the oil that I usually fry things with. And when the oil gets hot, I drop the first one in. And because we can't put slits in these like we do with the fried cakes or the fried jacks, you kind of have to hold it down with the tongs to make sure both sides cook, okay? Take a look. See, this is the second one. And what's going to happen, because it doesn't have the slits, it's going to kind of poof up or puff up on us. See these big air bubbles here? You just kind of want to, you know, not be too aggressive, but just release them gently. And then when you flip the bread over, you kind of hold it down with the tongs to make sure that it's cooked on both sides, okay? Simple as that. Now it's time to dress or bill our taco. So I have ground beef, I have some tomato and onions cut up here, some sour cream, lettuce, cheese, and I've cut up some jalapenos. And see how they look? We have 3. I'm gonna dress the prettier one. And I'm gonna put the ground beef first, and I'm using a fork because I kinda wanna drain off the gravy because I don't want my taco to be soggy. And in this salsa, I have tomatoes and onions, and it's soaked in distilled white vinegar because the distilled white vinegar will knock that heat off of the onion, and it will also make you not have bad breath when you eat the onion. So here comes a dollop of the sour cream, and if you don't like sour cream, omit this part. Some of the lettuce, and I'm going slowly because I want it to be so pretty because I want it to look good for my thumbnail, right? And then here comes the cheese, and then don't forget the jalapenos. So it's almost ready. This is going to be a really, really fantastic taco. Take a look from this angle. See how gorgeous it is. See how beautiful the bread is. It's not soggy at all. And then from this view, and of course, don't forget the aerial view. Oh my goodness, this is going to be so delicious.
I want to give a quick shout out to my cousin Tim and his wife Sarah and the 3 children, Emily, Isabella, and Andrew. They live in Alaska, and Sarah is a Native American, and I wanted to do justice to this meal because I spoke with her mom the other day, and she told me that our Belizean fried jack are the base for the Navajo tacos. So that's when I got the idea to do this, and I'm so glad I did. If you guys liked the video, hit like below for me. Please share it with your friends and family, and until I see you guys again, take care.
It's pretty good.
Thank you so much for liking the video and subscribing. Please check out my other two channels, the product review channel, Bear Pantry Talk, and come have some fun with my family and me over at the vlog channel, Babs Bear Talk.